show based on that film, which was fantastic. What was your reaction?
Well, first of all, the fact that everybody involved with the film was involved with the show kind of made it stick out. Because, like, you know, if it was something where, like, oh, we're going to remake that movie into a series, it's just a little bit of a different situation. I think looking at it saying, wow, there's been this great world that's been created with the film, and now the same exact people, all the way to Bradley Cooper acting in it, are going to now transpose it into television, and hours and hours of TV in this expanded universe, was one of the first things that I was really attracted to. Also, Mark Webb directed, it was awesome. And I think originally, I think it was supposed to be Neil Burger, who directed the movie. So, I mean, it was down to the team, the exact same creative team from the film. And then last minute they swapped for Mark, which is great. I love Mark.
500 Days of Summer, both Spider-Mans, which is great.
So there's like a creative aspect that felt like it puts it in like a category that you can trust.
And the pedigree, for me, you just look at the pedigree of the show and what Jake was just saying about Bradley Cooper is a huge star. He doesn't have to be involved. And it always gives you an indication. He decides that he's going to actually not only executive produce, but also be in the show as his character. That shows you that we're shooting for top, top, top quality. It's not just like there could be some projects where some star throws their name on it and says, send me some tweets that I'm going to copy and paste about it. Right? Right. Clearly, that's not the case in this situation. So everybody is reaching for something great. And you can tell by watching the pilot, it's so good. Jennifer Carpenter was fantastic. He's fantastic. Every character's great. The directing's great. The cinematography's great. And so that's important. And so who knows? We hope people are going to watch it, but at least we can be proud of what we know we're putting on the screen.
Yeah. And honestly, I mean, like, as exciting as it is, everybody involved, those are just the things, you know, you notice on an appointment sheet before you actually read the script. And then you read the script and realize that it's coming of a story from a real creative angle. It's not just recreating the movie. It's saying, like, oh, here's how we can get the most mileage out of that idea. It's just kind of compounding it. Like, Greg wrote a really awesome script for an actor who really fun to play. And Bradley does one of the things, you know, kind of Bradley's pitch to me. He was like, dude, as an actor, this is one of the favorite things I got to do. This is playing two characters, the duality of who you are before you encounter this pill, and then you become after you take this pill. And it's a Venn diagram, like the guy that you are now, experience a life he never thought was possible. So it's a real cool journey. As he explained, it was for him, for anybody that kind of steps in the role of someone picks NZT.
What was
funnest part? Because, you know, I think we really wanted to get there to be a similarity between how anyone acts on NZT. No matter your background, whoever you are, when you take that drug, you all go to like a certain level of enlightenment. It's just like, these are all the notes like Bradley gave me when he took the movies. Like, your stand up's greater, you talk deliberately, you know, no gesture is wasted, it all has a purpose, a lot of eye contact, just the technical notes of NZT. And when you're off, just have fun with it. Like, you can slouch, be a totally different guy. Someone compared like Brian off NZT to the dude from Big Lebowski, which I thought was awesome. But no, I mean, it was challenging, but in the best ways. I mean, that's kind of what you hope out of anything else to do. It's a healthy, creative challenge. You don't want to just coast through it.
What was the scene or moment or line of dialogue that really hooked you into that first script that you read?
That's like a scene or line of dialogue? Well, every action sequence is really pretty awesome. But I think the first part of the script that I was really like, this is going to be great, was when Brian first takes NZT. It's before it kind of develops into a procedural, like, chased by the FBI. He's got to use it to prove his innocence. Because there was such a wish fulfillment part. Like, the part in the movie where Bradley's speaking Italian, like, going to nice restaurants and giving people stock advice, and kind of just riding high on the effects of drugs. We do that in the show, where you, like, go around giving people, like, business advice, and you're all of a sudden incredible at the guitar, you know? I was like, that's going to be great, because that can be the thread, and there's such joy associated with it. It'll set it up for to be a really fun series, but then also ask the question, like, this dude's high. Like, your main character's high.
guy. Like, he's not. That's weird. Like, where is that going to go? How are we going to talk about that? I think it's a really interesting dark side of the show that, you know, it's going to unfold in the first season, second season, and so on.
We've got to cut it here. Oh, really quickly with Kelly.
Is it, for me, if you look at what he just said, this NZT is like a performance-enhancing drug, and we see it in athletics with steroids. There are side effects to that, and there are side effects here, so there's ramifications. And it's like, let's be clear. If we're offered a pill that says you can take this to lose weight, people take the pill. If you're offered a pill that says you can bat 300 or lift more weights or look better, people take that pill. If you're offered something that says you don't have to sleep, you'll be more focused, and you'll be able to retain more information and all this, people take that pill. And oftentimes we take it without thinking about what else is happening to us or our body. And I think that the show can entertain those questions as well. And also characters, like my character, an FBI agent, interacting with someone who's taking the pill, how much does my character know about it? How much does he feel challenged or threatened by someone who's better than him, ostensibly, because they're on a chemical, not because that they're inherently better or smarter? And so, almost like a synthetic advantage, what does that mean? Is there jealousy involved? Is there envy? Does that mean my character wants to take it despite the side effects? It's very interesting stuff.
It's pretty relevant today.
It's totally relevant.
Yeah.
Today. Totally
all right,
relevant.
We've got to cut it right there.